We should take down the creepy masks if we don't want to scare the buyers away.
Oh, so now you don't want to scare someone with those masks.
Are these authentic, Linket?
I doubt it.
I'm surprised Marianne would buy fakes.
20 years ago, everyone was buying fakes.
She took so many pictures.
Yeah. Like she had to document every second of our lives.
You can keep some of them, if you want.
No thanks.
Wow. I'm so embarrassed for us. Many Da Vinci's we were not.
She saved every drawing we ever did.
There's a couple of these I might keep. I don't remember these.
It's probably one of Marianne's unfinished masterpieces.
There's two of them. Maybe they were us. In some weird way that only made sense to Marianne.
What are you reading?
A letter we wrote her. To apologize for breaking that stupid vase, remember?
Bore your kids into good behavior. Great parenting strategy.
She pinched every penny. Old textbooks. Tessa gave them to us, right?
Yeah, she thought we were gifted.
We were. Just not like she thought. You think she knew we were sharing answers?
We shared for fun. We both knew them all anyway.
She was trying to save the planet way before Al Gore made it cool.
Has Al Gore ever made anything cool?
Nah.
I guess she was right about one thing. But you can't really blame anyone for not listening to crazy Marianne Ronan.
Mom? About me joining the hockey team? Mom!
Sorry, what? Not now. Maybe next year.
But you promised!
Keep whining, and my next year will become never.
Can you cut my hair?
Your hair is fine.
But I want to cut it short, really short.
What? Look, I'm tired, and I'm busy. Let's talk about this later.
You always say that.
Marianne said no to everything. Made me so pissed.
She was always on edge those last few months.
Yeah, and completely deaf to everything I was telling her I needed. Guess we never had time to complete the collection.
These came out of one of the prize machines at the Vecchi store, right?
Yeah, you'd slide the quarters inside on the little tray, and then magic, out pops a sticker. String, glue, duct tape. The holy trinity of house repair.
Marianne loved having something to fix.
But not the part where it got broken. The speck.
Huh. This bathroom still smells like Marianne.
A good scrub and we'll be rid of that too.
What would little Tyler think if he walked in here right now and saw me? What are we gonna do with all her jewelry?
Well, I'm certainly not gonna wear it.
Donation pop, handmade soap. Still here after 10 years. Impressive.
You could say that about the entire house.
If you don't come up soon, I'm gonna take whatever I want from our bedroom.
No way! Wait for me!
Now this... this feels like home. Look what I found!
What?
Only our greatest creation, the Book of Goblins.
Seriously? It was in that chest the whole time?
all these stories.
I had ideas for so many more.
Marianne wrote a lot of them.
Yeah. It's one of the only times I remember her being at peace.
Where is it?
You looking for something in particular?
My diary.
You never told me about it.
Yeah. With the way Marianne was, I tried extra hard to keep it a secret. Marianne. Yeah, that day she found out about it.
Mom, where is it? What did you do with it?
What now?
I can't find my diary. I know you stole it. Give it back.
Sweetie, whatever I do, it's just for your benefit.
You read it, didn't you? You had no right to do that.
I have the right to do whatever I need to protect my little girl.
I'm not your girl. I hate you.
You will always be my little girl. And no matter how hard you fight me, I'll fight twice as hard to keep you safe.
I don't know how I never saw it coming. She told me right to my face. She was willing to hurt me to keep me from transitioning.
Tyler, there is no way you could have known she'd go that far.
I want my diary back. Her room was the only place I didn't look.
Okay, but do you need to get it, like, now?
That diary was important to me, Allison. Writing down my thoughts helped me realize who I am.
Well, then let's go find it.
You think her room is still locked?
It always was. I'm not looking forward to going in there.
I know, but we'll have to eventually, and I need it back. Hey, the postcard we sent ourselves from Juno.
Forever alone.
What?
We barely had any friends. We even had to be our own pen pals.
Tyler, do you copy? If we don't move fast, this whole thing is going to melt. Do you copy?
We're basically walkie-talkies on legs, you know.
Yeah, well, how do you play Ice Road Trucker Assassins without a walkie-talkie, right?
Yeesh. Mr. Serious all of a sudden.
Ice King finally caught the hag. His furious voice could be heard throughout the forest. For your wickedness, you will be eternally bound to the lake.
What? No way. Quiet, let me finish.
You will no longer be allowed to leave. Not even under a full moon. The moon hag was imprisoned in the lake. And she never again tried to escape. And then the title. What do you think? Not bad, right?
I guess that's okay. But I would have changed the end.
What? No way!
The Ice King. I totally forgot about him.
That's because it was dangerous to mention his name. He was too powerful.
Where'd you come from?
Hold up.
What?
Remember this?
Unfortunately.
You must solve my riddle to earn the right to enter the princess's sanctum.
Nothing a good hard shove won't take care of.
I mean, yes, we could brute force it, but it might be kind of fun to finally solve it, right?
We have different definitions of the word fun.
Okay, well, if we break it, we're just gonna have to fix it for the sale. So let's at least try not to. You have the Book of Goblins?
Yep.
Hand it over.
What are you looking for?
The image on the door. It's making me think of a story from the book. One that Marianne wrote.
You have a way better memory than me.
Well, the Book of Goblins was my creation.
And you'll never let anyone forget it.
Here it is. The one about the princess's party. Give it a read. I think the symbols may represent something in the story.
First ghost memories, now storybook puzzles. What a weird day.
What a weird childhood.
Touché. Yeah, I can try again. And boom. We're in.
After so many years, I expected this to feel more, you know, like a win.
Speak for yourself. I'm the one who solved the riddle.
Why do I feel like you're not gonna let me forget that? Where do you think we should start looking?
I don't know. Where in this mess would she stash someone else's personal thoughts?
Whatever's going on, they won't let me in. used to tell me everything, but they shut me out, Tessa. They've shut me out. I've had so much on my plate lately, and they're convinced I'm the enemy, and I don't know why. I need them. I need my goblins.
I remember now. We heard her crying. We listened through the door.
Seeing her like this, as if she's still here,
it really sucks.
She was really coming apart those last few months, wasn't she?
She and Tessa were best friends, until suddenly they weren't. Wonder what happened.
Either Tessa got sick of Marianne's moods, or Marianne got sick of Tessa's judgment. So she was standing here, spying through the window, drawing us while we played.
She always had her eye on us.
My entire body just shivered.
Straight in the trash?
No. I bet we could sell it on the internet.
True. Maybe we could sell it to the guy who collects John Wayne Gacy's clown paintings. I tried to read this one. I can never figure out the order of the chapters, though.
Didn't the author go insane or something? No wonder Marianne liked it.
It's here. I knew it. I fucking knew it.
Do you think she read it?
Of course. She was nosy as hell.
Tyler.
What?
Look.
What? Where did you find that?
It was on her desk with her papers.
Seriously? Are you fucking kidding me?
Look, we gotta be really careful not to overthink this.
It doesn't make any sense. She was mad, right? She was mad I cut my hair. She attacked me because I cut my hair.
She was mad and she attacked you. We both saw it.
Then what is this shit?
I don't know. I don't know. Tyler, come here.
She can't do this to me. Not now, when I've finally made sense of a few things.
Well, that was your first mistake, thinking the world made any kind of sense. Ten years in the grave, and she's still finding new ways to piss us off.
Yeah. I think I need some air. Thank you.
Are you really, really sure? I am. Do it. Okay. Here we go. Whoa. Is it all gone? Yeah. It looks amazing. Really?
Yeah.
I can't wait to show Mom. She's been so sad lately.
More than sad.
She's been scary. Yeah, but not tonight, though. It was almost like a party. Thank you, Allison.
You don't have to thank me.
You're my sister. I feel more like... your brother.
Brother, sister, we look out for each other. But I'm pretty sure I just gave you a really bad haircut.
Mom? Mom?
Glad we found your diary.
Me too.
I guess she was trying to figure out where you were at.
Yeah, well, she should have asked. I wasn't some goddamn research project, I was her child.
About the book.
Raising your transgender child? Do you even know how rare these books were in 2005? Was she trying to figure out how to support me?
Maybe.
But she wasn't trying. She never...
It doesn't make sense. I know. You cutting your hair was what set her off, right?
Allison, she read my diary. She already knew. It wasn't my hair. And if we were wrong about that... Fuck.
You think she read it. It's possible she never even opened the diary, and that things are exactly like we always thought they were.
But if she did, and they aren't...
God, Tyler. Sure. I mean, we could have been wrong. But what good does it do to ask the question now?
You mean other than not having to live with the thought that my mom tried to kill me for being me?
Tyler, I know you want there to be something to find. Something that'll make it all make sense. But she was unhinged.
So that's it then. She was crazy. Nothing else to say.
I think we'd be better off if we tried to move on.
Why don't we talk to a few people who knew her? See if that book makes any sense to them.
People don't want to talk about Marianne. They pretend like that night never happened.
Must be nice to be able to forget.
So, say we get our answers, and it becomes crystal clear Marianne didn't attack you because of your hair. What then?
We deal with it when we get there. But knowing that would mean everything to me.
I get it.
What about Tessa? She was Marianne's closest friend. Let's ask her about it.
Sure. But I'll warn you, she's particularly touchy about this subject.
Well, maybe she'll talk to me. I was always her favorite.
Operative word, was. But we need to go by the store anyway, to get a few things for the repairs.
Great. Two seagulls, one stale hunk of bread.
I'm not sure I like that analogy.
Listen, I know you don't want to keep talking about this.
But you're obviously not going to be satisfied until we do. So let's talk.
So, we have a plan?
Yep. We ask around about Marianne, but we also stick to our repair schedule.
Sounds good to me.
Holly's diary. It's been a long time since I heard that name.
Was I the only one who ever called you that?
Actually, no. I used it at Fireweed for a while, until I settled on Tyler. Most people were pretty chill about the switch. Not everyone, though.
What do you mean?
I had a mentee who refused to call me Tyler. He didn't want my help. He didn't want anyone's help.
I'm sorry. I like the name Tyler, by the way.
Thanks.
Not a bad view, right?
I forgot how beautiful it is.
Remember that time we tried to cross the lake after it froze over?
Oh yeah, how can I forget? Marianne lectured us for an hour.
Well, she wasn't wrong, at least. It was really dangerous. If we'd fallen in, no more goblins.
We grew up on this lake. We know how to spot thin ice.
I think I'd like to end up somewhere like this, just not here.
Somewhere with more trees than people?
Exactly.
Just go into it with a little more of a plan than Marianne did.
Already working on it. With my degree, it'll be easy to get a job as a ranger.
After you spend a little time in Juneau?
Still a maybe on that one. Nice ring. Gift from your boyfriend?
Come on. I told you I'm not with anyone right now. Don't rub it in.
Why does it look familiar?
It was a gift from Eddie. He had them both made at the same time.
Both? Oh, wait.
Yeah. The ring was supposed to be linked to the one he tried to give you.
Why didn't you tell me?
I didn't think you were gonna toss the ring my foster father gave you overboard.
I'm sorry. I'm an ass.
You are. But I get it.
Alright. I think that's enough time enjoying the view.
I wasn't gonna say anything, but...
Yeah, I know. I was the one all eager to go, and then I started waxing poetic about the landscape.
Go ahead. I'll catch up. Need to respond to a message.
My sister. The social butterfly.
Seems we got a trespasser.
What the fuck?
You got 5 seconds to talk me into defending my property.
Your property?
5, 4.
I'm Tyler.
Don't know any Tylers. 3, 2.
Sam!
Ellie? What are you doing out here, girl?
This is our house.
Was I talking to you?
Sam, put the gun down. This is Tyler. My brother.
Your brother? Oh, shit. Huh. I guess I heard about all that, but I never... Damn, you look like a real man.
So do you, Sam.
You know what I mean. I just didn't know they could make a woman look so much like a man.
Not a woman who looks like a man, Sam. A man. A real man, just like you.
Oh, shit. Guess I'm the asshole again. You gotta excuse us, old guys.
I really don't.
Come on. You kids keep changing the rules. You can't expect us to keep up.
Just respect the people are who they say they are. It's not hard.
No, it ain't hard, but it just takes some getting used to.
We'll get used to it, because we aren't going anywhere. So, what are you doing here exactly?
Oh, well, I've been kind of keeping an eye on this place for you, you know? It's like patching the roof, checking the pipes, and all that stuff.
Thank you, Sam.
Oh, yeah, it's, that's no big deal. I just, you know, your mama, she was a special lady. She deserved much better than, you know, what you got.
Didn't you used to help Marianne with repairs and building projects?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, seeing as your mama never had a man around, I just, you know, took it on myself to help her keep this place standing.
How antiquated of you.
Thanks. I guess you two are still aiming to sell the place?
That's the plan. Which, by the way, we need your keys.
Since apparently you went and changed the locks?
Oh yeah, absolutely. But, selling your mother's house? Are you sure? Bad or good? It's all you've got left of her.
Not all. I'm sure the gun she tried to kill us with is still somewhere in there.
Tyler!
What?
What Tyler means is, a fresh start is what we both need.
Of course. This place has got to be full of all kinds of bad memories. But maybe some good ones, too?
Can you hear me?
Ty, we can't do this when we're in the middle of talking to someone.
But this is pointless. He's hammered.
He's always hammered. And who knows? Maybe it'll make him chatty. Now come on. People think our family is weird enough.
Everything okay with you two?
Yes.
No.
Oh. All right.
How well did you know her?
Not as well as I thought. Well, I heard what happened that night. Well, I figured people were bullshitting me.
It really surprised you, didn't it?
Much as anything ever has. Other folks say they saw it coming. Not me.
Did you help with her door?
Her door?
The puzzle on her bedroom door.
Oh. Oh, yeah. You two kept sneaking in, giving her no privacy, huh? You ever solve it?
Yep. Better late than never, I guess.
Never solved it myself. I mean, not that I wanted to. Guess you know all your mama's secrets now, huh?
Well. She may have one or two left.
We should get going.
That's all you think we'll get out of him?
He's too wasted to be of any more help.
I'll tell him to get a move on then.
Well, we've got a supply run to make, and Uncle Eddie's expecting a visit, so.
Right. Yeah, of course. Get going, you two.
Sam? We all gotta get going.
Oh. Of course. Of course, yeah, I got lots to do myself. Lots of to-dos on old Sam's list. And you don't want to keep Brown waiting, you know?
Thanks for looking out for this place.
Happy to do it. Don't hesitate to reach out if you need anything. Anything at all. You hear?
Sam?
Huh?
Sam?
Huh?
The keys?
Oh, yeah. Of course. Of course. Yeah, they're yours. This place, it meant a lot to your mother. It almost felt like it was a part of her, and it's like some part of her is alive here still.
Hopefully the house doesn't turn out to be a murderous psycho that tries to kill us in our sleep, huh?
Yeah. Well, take care of yourself, both of you.
Hey, so we really do have a lot to do.
Okay, go on. I'll be right behind you.